What's up guys, it's Tommy here and welcome to the Germany-Hungary post-match analysis video, and I will show you also fan zone footage of the second Hungary goal where the fan zone went absolute crazy.
Az hihetetlen. Az gyönyörű! Azt a mindenit! Na nézzük, nem volt lesz? Az ügyelés tudod érni. Hát az...
Sajnos esnek sem fogják látni.
Az se, az se az. Az szal. Nem hiszem el.
Most hogyha Benz lesz a tényszerző hivatalosan.
Á, mellé ütött?
Viszont azt akkor meg kellene nézni, hogy vajon...
Hát, mellé ütött.
Szépen
ezt most szépen kiátszották, ez a baj.
Annyi jó játékos, hogy másodszor is érnyelít. Mindegyik a 83. 84. percet. Az első gól. A labda és aztán szemben a kapuval óriási erővel lő, megpattan a lába,
megpattan Gulácsi lába. Igen, megpattant a védőn is, látod?
Két gól, nem a kapus, és mégis bejut.
Basszus, kegyetlen, de én nagyon büszke vagyok erre a csapatra. Nem baj, szép volt, fiúk! Bulgaria. Real, Bulgaria.
I'm so incredibly proud of this team. I think Hungary became a lot of people's second team at the Euros. Let me know what you think about my national team's performance, because this group of devs will probably be remembered for the next 10 or 20 years as one of the craziest, most memorable groups in international football history, because honestly, there were so many incredible permutations. Hungary were fourth at the start of the match day, but we were actually third and qualifying for the knockout stages from the 13th minute after Salah scored. I couldn't record the Salah goal. Yeah, I didn't record the whole game on my phone, but that was just a crazy celebration as well. And Hungary were actually only trailing, so only behind, for 12 minutes in the whole of the Euros group stage. To put that into perspective, Hungary played like 297 minutes in total at the Euros so far, and they were only trailing for 12 minutes against the current world champions France, against the current European champions Portugal, and against the previous world champions Germany. And Germany played all their home games at home, and Hungary were 5 or 6 minutes away from knocking Germany out, which is absolutely incredible, and it shows how far this Hungary team has done, that we were bitterly disappointed and heartbroken after getting a draw in Munich, which is a brilliant result for Hungary, but it didn't result in qualification, so we were bitterly disappointed. And Germany looked like they were going out until the 84th minute, and it was a heartbreaking goal, because the first Germany shot gets deflected. It's a loose ball, Leon Goretzka shoots, it gets deflected again, and that's why Gulácsi could only get a toe to it, but he couldn't keep it out. It was a heartbreaking moment, but honestly, the Schäfer goal, we went absolutely mental in the fan zone here in Budapest. And I actually had tickets for this game in Munich, but I decided not to go and to sell the tickets to some of my close friends who live in Munich, because there were a lot of border restrictions, but also because we got the Russian vaccine, me and my girlfriend, we weren't sure whether we would be allowed to enter into the stadium, and it looks like we would have had to take a PCR test, and with all the traveling and everything else, and we have so many things going on as well in our personal lives. My grandfather just got out of a hospital recently, my girlfriend, her grandfather just passed away. We had the funeral last Saturday. So we had so many things going on in our personal life. We decided not to go, but still watching in a fan zone with 11,000 fellow Hungarian fans was still a brilliant experience. And I hope that I can convey that in this video as well. But what a performance, what an absolutely crazy group. I mean, Germany at the start of this group were second, and then they were fourth, then they were third, then fourth, then they were second, then they were fourth, and then they were second again, and Germany will meet Belgium in the knockout stages. Germany will meet England in the knockout stages at Wembley. I'm already looking forward to that game. England-Germany is always an incredible game. And Portugal will meet Belgium. So I'm sure that Portugal are not happy with just getting a draw against France, because Portugal at one point were also looking likely to get, they could get eliminated. So except France, every team were basically second, third, and fourth in this group on the last match day at one point or another in the game, which is absolutely crazy, absolutely mind-blowing, and it just shows what a brilliant group of death this was. And Hungary played like an absolutely incredible warrior team. We upset the odds. We were leading against France for a long time, and then we get a very, very well-deserved draw. And we were leading twice against Germany in Munich, in the Allianz Arena, and that is just absolutely incredible, mind-blowing, when nobody gave Hungary a fighting chance. Absolutely nobody said that Hungary could even get a 1 point in this group. We were supposed to get thrashed three times by two or three goals at least. And yes, against Portugal we lost by three goals, but that game also was 0-0 until the 84th minute, and we actually scored the goal, the opening goal, but it was ruled out for offside. So, I mean, even against Portugal, we were 6 minutes away from getting a draw. Absolutely crazy. We were 6 minutes away from getting a win in Germany. I just can't speak highly enough of this team. And also a lot of these players are like 23, 24 years old or even younger. So this team has the next 4 to 6 years a great journey ahead of them. We will play England in September here in Budapest. I will try to get tickets for that game, because watching England live and watching potentially Trent Alexander-Arnold, Jordan Henderson, Joe Gomez would be absolutely brilliant, and it's one of my dreams as well to watch England live as well, to perform. And here in Budapest, I think we have a chance to get a result against them. I mean, after almost winning in Germany, after getting a draw against world champions France, when nobody gave us a chance, why not? Let's try and qualify for the World Cup, something that Hungary hasn't done since 1986. Just sit for a second and think about it. 1986 was the last time we qualified for the World Cup. And also before the 2016 Euros, where we qualified for the knockout stages, in style, we actually won our group when we had Portugal, Iceland and Austria in our group. And I'm convinced that if we had at least one more, like, smaller nation in our group, we would have been comfortably qualifying to the knockout stages, but it wasn't to be. Hungary, actually, I think this way it's maybe more memorable than if we were in an easier group and we qualified and then we got knocked out in the last 16. I think this way this tournament became more memorable for Hungary, because nobody gave Hungary a chance. Everybody was writing us off and we upset the odds so many times. I'm so proud of this team. Hajrá, Magyarok! Come on, Hungary! Let's do it! Let's qualify for the World Cup. That's our next mission. I really hope that you guys enjoyed this video. Thanks for watching. Have a nice day. See you later, guys. Good night.